I'm gonna call it modeling in the flow, stay in the flow all the time. One of the most important things is finding your planes the easiest way inside an assembly, right? And for example, if I'm trying to find where is the major plane or one of the major planes of this part, traditionally you had to select the part, see where it is in the tree, expand the feature manager. Hopefully you're going to find the plane. This is a very simple assembly. In other situations, it's much, much harder. Well, nowadays it's much, much easier. If you remember just one little shortcut, which is Q. So if I hover with my mouse over nothing and I press Q, notice how the major, actually all the planes and the origins of the main assemblies become visible temporarily. Then I can select something, I can apply a mate, I can create a sketch. The moment I click out, it disappears. What if I want to do something with components? For example, I would have, let's say, this component here and this component here, and I would like to get their planes aligned. Just hover over the first one, press the Q button, notice how the planes appear, select one of the planes. SOLIDWORKS is going to remember this selection. Hover over the other one, press Q, notice the planes of the second one became available. Hold Control, select the two planes. Now you can apply the relation. Let's say I'm going to make them coincident. Click out, everything goes away, right? So that's easy peasy. Notice at any time, actually at all the times, I was focusing just on the model. My mouse didn't move to the left, didn't move to the right, and my mind was focused on those two parts. Now let's go one step further. Let's insert a sub-assembly here. And this is a nice little sub-assembly. And I'm going to try to mate these two together. This is the main assembly is fixed, or the components of the top level assembly. This sub-assembly requires to be placed somewhere here. The moment you start applying mates, this thing is going to go in its place, and maybe you're going to be able to apply the first mate easy, but the next ones is going to be a problem, especially when one of the two components that you try to assemble is so much smaller or so we're very far away from the other one. And this is what I'm going to recommend first. So the two extraordinary tools that you can use. Number one, the breadcrumbs. So I want to select a sub-assembly, right? But when I click on this face, what I'm selecting is actually a face. In the feature tree, it kind of shows that I might have selected a part. Remember, I want to assemble a sub-assembly inside the top-level assembly. Fortunately, the moment you select something, SOLIDWORKS shows you the breadcrumbs. So if you remember the Hansel and Gretel story, they had some bread pieces in their pockets and their stepmother was really evil, wanted to get them lost in the forest. So they left some crumbs in their wake, hoping that they're gonna find them and find a way back. Unfortunately, there were birds there. They ate the breadcrumbs. In SOLIDWORKS, we don't have birds, so that is good. And pretty much it shows me the whole history of this face, right? This face was created by this feature. This feature was created by the sketch. The feature also belongs to this body. The body belongs to the part. And the cool thing, I can select the subassembly. And to make it my life even easier, remember what we want. We want to focus on the model. We don't want to move the mouse all the way here. This is very far away. What we're going to do instead, we're going to call the breadcrumbs next to my selection, next to my mouse. So I selected this face. I'm going to press the D button. The breadcrumbs comes here. So now when I go, I want to select an assembly. I simply press this button. It selected the assembly. The cool thing about this is that the context toolbar and the right mouse button menu are about what you just selected. So in this case, everything is about the assembly. And then I'm going to use my favorite tool in SOLIDWORKS called Component Preview Window, which allows me to open this assembly in its own window. And you can use the middle mouse button to rotate. You can zoom in, zoom out. So I can focus in this area on the main assembly and be able to select whatever I want from the little assembly. So let's start mating. I'm going to try to select this face and this face. And again, using the Quick Mate toolbar, another great tool, let's apply a concentric mate. It appears, right? Everything is there. Let's apply one more mate. I want this face. Notice how much easier it is to select this face versus trying to select the one that's obscured from the main assembly. Let's hold Control and select the other face. Let's apply coincident. And now the most important thing, or actually one of the flashiest things, how do I select something that is completely covered? I want to apply maybe a parallel mate between this face and something that I cannot really see. Well, take a look at what Component Preview Window can do. It has this nice little toolbar, and one of the options is to turn the representation of the subassembly inside the main assembly is transparent. So I can select through it. Look at that. I can hold control. I can select the other face. I can apply parallel. The job is done. This is pretty crazy in my mind. I remember when I was a user maybe 10 years ago, not having this tool or this set of tools would make this operation, maybe taking 2-3 minutes. That's one thing. But the other thing, my mind would have been completely confused. Maybe not completely, but would have my line of thoughts would have been derailed because I had to go in all these various places to find what I needed. So remember, SOLIDWORKS allows you to work on the model at all times, stay on the flow, and not only you're going to be faster, more productive, but you're going to go home rested. You're not going to have headaches, less frustration, just perfect. So yeah, that's the little tip that I wanted to share with you today.